Welcome to the Militia Gaming Community. I'm Trigger, and this is the best road e-build for the 2013 Toyota GT86. Let's go! The Militia Gaming Community and Dave Loves Games came together to create a community Discord. If you'd like to join the Discord, there's an invite link in the description down below. The GT86 is one of the starter car options, and it's actually the option that you're stuck with if you skip the game's tutorial. Since you are not earning a lot of money at the beginning of the game, I figured I would do some testing for this car and find out what are the best upgrades to buy without sending this car into the Road D class, so that racing the first couple of championships is a breeze. To give you an idea of how I tested this car, I basically built every configuration of this car that didn't go over the 299 PIR rating required to stay in the Road E class. There are several different thought processes when building a low-level car like this. Do you aim to maximize the acceleration, the handling, the braking, or the top speed? Or do you try to create the most well-rounded car you can? What type of build actually performs better on the track and doesn't just have the best stats? I ran each of the builds on the same track and aimed for the best possible lap time. And that, plus my experience driving the car, is what has led me to what I consider to be the best possible build for this GT86 in the Road E class. What really caught my attention when testing these different builds was how important the tires, the turbo, and the weight reduction was. These were the three most important upgrades for this starter car and made the most difference. Every other upgrade seemed to be an afterthought and something you would put on if you still had enough PIR in the build. So with that in mind, here's my recommendation. The biggest difference maker for this car was definitely the tires. When you add the Motorsport tires, which are the best tires you can equip, the handling receives a 7.7 point jump, which equates to lap times that were not hundredths, not tenths faster, they were seconds faster, just by changing the tires. After that, you might be tempted to make a suspension change, a bodywork change, or maybe even a weight reduction change, but the biggest problem for this car is its lack of power. So I dropped a Stage 1 turbo in it, which brought the rating up to 294 and provided a ridiculous 29.3 points to the acceleration and 8.2 points to the top speed, all at the cost of maxing out your rating. Since there are no upgrades that move the rating only 5 points, this is it. This is the build. To be clear, this is not the fastest Road E version of this car in a straight line. You can dump all your rating into upgrades that give you power, and trust me, I did that. The problem was, you have no real way to contain or handle that power. The car handles like crap, and my lap times were almost as slow as with no upgrades. I also built a version that was all handling, thinking that that would allow me to take the turns faster, and that also turned out to be a bad strategy. The car wasn't fast enough accelerating out of turns and on the straights. I found the balanced approach to be the best to run the fastest lap times. So there are really only two upgrades you need to make to this car to compete in the Road E class, and that's the Motorsport tires and the Stage 1 turbo. I really appreciate everyone watching, and trust me, there will be many more builds to come, so if you're interested in that kind of thing, stick around. Shout out to the Militia subs, you guys are literally the best. Alright, I'll catch you guys on the next one. Trigger out.